Ha! Hey! Look who I found! This is guy you guys all like!
Ah! Ah!
So, since I can just pop in wherever I want and see what people are doing, this reminds me of our favorite person who can do this, the devil. Why not think about the greatest devil that ever deviled? So our three criteria here. Number one, they have to represent evil in some way. They may not actually be evil, but they have to represent the idea. They have to be really smooth at what they're doing. They're a smooth operator. Number three, some level, even though it's the devil, you want him to succeed. This is Hades from the Disney classic Hercules, portrayed by James Woods, which we all love him. His whole concept is, you know what? Screw all of you gods, because why not? I'm going to destroy this one baby because, hey, he's gonna stop my plans later on. I don't care if I kill a baby. I don't care if it's a god baby. I'm gonna kill it. And the whole time we're like, dude, you're trying to kill a baby. And then later it's like, dude, you're trying to kill a guy who has the mental capacity of a baby.
Fair points. Fair points. But you're crazy. Really, the best devil. If we're looking for a representative of evil, we've got to go with Viggo Mortensen's portrayal of the devil in The Prophecy, starring Christopher Walken and Viggo Mortensen and some others. Christopher Walken is Gabriel, and he is basically doing bad things. He's the villain of the film, and Satan turns up towards the latter end of the film because what Gabriel is doing is evil, and that's his job. And that's really his whole motivation in the film.
He's got to out-evil the evil.
Exactly. He says, like, normally I'd stay out of this, but Gabriel is after a child and stuff. You know, you say that Hades is after a baby. Satan in The Prophecy is cool with that, but it's not him doing it. This is my domain. Get off my porch.
I mean, you got that with Hades too a bit. He knows his role in things. It's all about, like, how can I scheme everybody? And he's got the perfect scheming voice to go along. He's like a used car salesman, but he's really good at this. The whole time, the whole movie, he's like, okay, I'm gonna make a deal with you. I'm gonna make a deal with you. He's gonna get to the point, like, he knows Hercules is totally beating him. And he's like, I got nothing left. I'm already failing, but you know what? I'm gonna make you one last deal, because I'm totally gonna kill you on this one. You're not gonna refuse a handshake from James Woods' Hades here.
No, of course not, no. But the Satan of The Prophecy, he's a little less friendly. In fact, that's part of his charm, is he will let you straight up know that he thinks you're a piece of crap. He introduces himself with one woman who mistakes him for God at first and says, are you God? I mean, this is Aragorn from Lord of the Rings, perched like a bird on a rock. God is love. And I don't love you. It's perfect. Viggo Mortensen. You know, attractive as hell. Younger back in the day. But with this weird, just creepy, skeevy kind of oddness to him. At the end of the film, he vanquishes Christopher Walken and then just turns on the heroes with no subtlety whatsoever. The devil of The Prophecy is an ethical person. Evil as hell, but he's got standards.
I mean, Hades has standards too. And that's kind of why we like Hades, is he's like, you know what? I live here in Hades, of which I am named. This place is crap. Look where I live, man. Look who I deal with. I have a pond of just moaning people, which is not as attractive as that sounds when you see what the pond of moaning people looks like. And so his whole motivation is just, I don't want to live here anymore. I want to live up there. And so the whole time you're like, you know what? I know you're bad and you're going to destroy everyone, but I really want you to succeed. And this goes to the point where Hercules as a movie is not remembered fondly, but everyone can agree, well, I want to see Hades again. You can just fast forward to, oh, Hades is talking, let me watch this. Oh, he's not talking, let me fast forward. Oh, Hercules is doing a, you know, an 80s montage. Okay, Hades is back.
Yeah. I'm finding it really hard to disagree. I know there's normally some animosity in these things, but you make fantastic points. But with the devil of The Prophecy, you know, he also acknowledges his domain is evil. He's clearly got a bad rap in life, but he owns it. He owns it. There's just this elegant simplicity of his character. I'm not letting anybody take away what I have, which isn't much because he's the devil, but he'll be damned. He'll be damned twice if he's gonna let someone else take that from him, whatever little he's got. And it's hard not to be on his side because
the double damning is pretty damn bad.
Yeah,
Hades in Hercules has one of my favorite visuals of a Satan is. When he gets mad, his hair explodes more into flames. When he's just pissed, boom, there's fire everywhere. That's freaking sweet.
Imagine if halfway through the Fellowship of the Ring, Aragorn just perched on a rock and just started going, God is love, and I don't love you. It'd be pretty funny, I think. And if you view the prophecy as a sequel to The Lord of the Rings, where Aragorn went broke bad, basically. I needed a few seconds more to say that bit.
So Hades pulled out a win here. A win for Hades. We got one Hades. Very good.
Considering it's Hades, I can soak up that loss.
Sure. My final word here, I did beat you, I believe. So I do absorb some power. So for now, thank God for me.